Two seasons ago, Nottingham Forest came here, got a point in a 0-0 draw, and that was enough to win them the Football League Championship. At the end of 1979, they come here to Highfield Road looking to end a sequence that's seen them go to six away matches and come away without so much as a point. Their lineup this afternoon is unchanged from the team which beat Aston Villa on Boxing Day and thereby ended a run in which they've taken just 1 point out of a possible 12. Just one unfamiliar face indeed in their kit, although familiar enough to followers of football generally, and Match of the Day in particular, that of Stanley Bowles, who joined the club from Queen's Park Rangers on December the 10th. It's young Tom English, who scored what proved to be the decisive goal in Coventry's victory at Derby on Boxing Day, and he keeps his place in the Coventry team that shows two changes from that occasion. They're without Wallace and without Gooding, who was sent off in that match, so they bring the experienced Coop in at number 4 and Steve Hunt at number 11. And the lineups you'll notice we put out in 1 to 11 because to explain how Coventry hope to play against Forest would be much too complicated for a formation caption. But it's clearly still very much the festive season. Looking at the pitch, it's hard to believe we're halfway through the season. Really marvellous work done on it, and the great advantage gained from polythene piping underneath the surface. Clive White gets the game under the way with Coventry attacking the goal to our right. Coventry in their usual sky blue strip, Nottingham Forest in their usual also red shirts and white shorts. Be a foul by Ferguson. Brian Clough and Peter Taylor. Well, the head was down as much as the foot was up. Coop coming forward to take Bowles. Looks a useful player playing in the way he's playing this afternoon. Behind the back four by and large. A good challenge by Roberts. Contest within a contest. Roberts and Son. Bowles, that's a lovely turn. But it was away from Bertels, comes to Anderson, who turned like a top, but made just a brushing acquaintance with the ball. Hunt for Coventry. Ferguson down the middle, lent on a bit by Gray, and the free kick given. Five in the wall at the moment in front of Peter Shilton. Hutchison with his foot on the ball, McDonald just behind. Hunt away to the left. Holton now making an extra man on the end of the wall. And McDonald has the crack. Here's Roberts, if he can turn quickly enough. Blair. Held it well. But not for long enough. And Robertson wandering off the touchline for the first time. And Bowles taking his position. Well, that asked a bit much. By Burns, who looks in good nick at the back, and that makes such a difference to Forest. Here's Francis, that's a good run, and Coop's tackle doing exactly the job. Francis makes the through run, he meets him. Bowles, Anderson up on the far side of the box. Bertels, Robertson. An arm there from Roberts, and the free kick will be indirect for obstruction. Bertels in the 6-yard box, plenty more coming from behind. Ferguson's header, not a particularly good one actually. Now there was the pass from Francis. Oh, there's a possible break here. English has got a hold on. Oh, in fact, the yellow card has been given, Burns for that challenge. Well, he knew he was exposed, that he had to win it, and he stretched over the ball, I would suggest. Certainly that was the referee's viewpoint. On by Blair, here's English, but it picked up too much pace when it landed. It was well claimed by Peter Shilton. Burns. Nicely done by Gillespie. Curious from Lloyd. McDonald. Hutchison. Space on the left, and he's found Hunt. Ferguson and English in the middle. Four behind those two. And Ferguson looked as though he was nudged, but I think that it was in a genuine attempt by Lloyd to get to the ball. According to Mr. White, getting the man first before the ball. Referee takes another check of the watch. And that check was the last. And the action now moves to the dressing rooms at the end of a lively but unproductive half, with the scoreline exactly as it has been for the last two seasons here, 0-0. In spite of the efforts of many, particularly, I think, Bobby McDonald of Coventry City. Coventry's home record this season shows 7 wins, 1 draw, and 2 defeats. But they have been such an inconsistent side. They've won enough matches to be well up the top, but they've lost enough and conceded enough goals to be down the bottom. And only twice have they managed to win 2 matches consecutively. Forest having their worst run since coming out of the First Division. All this season they've played 118 games in all competitions and lost just 8. But they've already been beaten 8 times this season in 32. Here's Tom English for Coventry. That's the first time he's got away, really. Gray back goal side of him. Ferguson, he gave the ball to the man most heavily marked, actually, instead of spreading it out. Hutchison, Ferguson and McDonald and Lloyd. Bertels. Robertson. Coop. McDonald. Quite sharp behind ball. Certainly didn't look like it to me, or more importantly to the referee. Ferguson. Oh, that's nice, from Blair to English. How can he get the finish in? He's under pressure. And Blair miskicks, and Ferguson hits it against McGovern. Well, having played the ball wide to Hunt, I think it was really demanded of Hunt to have a cracker goal, but he put it back, and nobody seemed to want to take the real responsibility because the two shots were somewhat half-hearted. McGovern. In the meantime, Bertels is on the floor, and the free kick is given Coventry's way. Mick Coop has got three players up on the 18-yard line, three behind those three. And Larry Lloyd met it. Gillespie, McDonald's. And Bertels is someone on his toe at the moment. But he got a free kick for that. And I think the truth about that, which gets a booking for Holton, was that he missed the challenge with one foot and got the man with the other. Defenders still winning out, but now at the expense of two bookings. No complaint from Jim Holton, who will miss the cup tie next week. He'll be suspended after the game against Middlesbrough, having already reached 20 points. So he's already moved on to phase two. Here's Hunt. Blair was not surely by Bowyer. Yes, he was. Collier presumably will replace Holton next week. English. Bowles. Anderson. Francis going down the middle. Four involved in this attack for Forrest. Bertels. And a penalty has been given. Holton going with Bertels, and presumably the referee feeling that the challenge was such that it held Bertels down as Bertels tried to flick the ball around with his head. Holton, to put it mildly, disappointed. Bertels showing no reaction at all. And John Robertson waiting to take the penalty. 5 minutes of the second half gone. And Robertson with a chance to beat Les Seeley, which he does comfortably enough. Smile from John Robertson, who's had a very frustrating afternoon to date. But a very comfortably taken penalty breaks the deadlock. Holton adjudged the culprit. Bertels off in chase, but that belongs to Seeley, who went the wrong way when he was asked to make a save for the first time in the match. English, Blair, Hunt pulling away, Francis watching, and the first time Shilton's had to make a save, and it was a very good one. And Burns is having a word. Shilton is hurt, because it seemed there was a foot up then from Ferguson. It really was a very good save by Shilton, because he had to come for the ball, he got it clean on the knuckles away, and he was caught by the foot of Ferguson as a centre-forward challenged. John O'Hare in the foreground having a word with Trevor Francis, and the linesman is not too happy about that, running off in chase of O'Hare. And the referee will now get involved in this. Well, the referees, presumably the opinion they weren't discussing what won the 3:30. And a booking for John O'Hare. Well, if he was passing on messages, he takes back a message that there's a booking added to Nottingham Forest. France is again looking up at the bench. I wonder whether when he talked to John O'Hare, the message was coming from the field to the manager rather than the other way around. Francis. And that hurts. But it was his own fault, I think, Hunt. Anderson out to the right. Now Francis. Corner. Defenders and attackers on the near post, but quite a gathering. Here's McGovern. Anderson. Just too far away, he took it. But after lots of pressure, Forrest coming out again. Pressure on them by Coventry, I mean. Francis. Well, that could have run anywhere. Runs to Robertson. Sixty-seven minutes gone, and really a very easy goal. Second easy goal in the match for John Robertson. Francis's pass, bisecting the area. Number of players should have cleared it. No one did, and Robertson helped himself to a belated Christmas present. So it now looks as though Nottingham Forest have broken this depressing sequence away from home. And Ferguson with a first-time shot well wide. John Robertson, two touches, two goals of some simplicity. And it was Francis who set it up, although he really shouldn't have been allowed to do so. The ball travelled a long way past a number of legs. Offering himself, and Anderson, we hit that well, the goalkeeper saved it with his knees and pays for it with a goal by Stanley Bowles. Well, no need to question how you do it, Stanley, that was too easy for him. And sadly for Les Seely, it was his error, because for some extraordinary reason he blocked the original shot with his knees, and the ball curling up to give Bowles just the job of climbing to nod in. So Bowles, two goals in successive matches. Steve Hunt hasn't had enough pace to trouble him. And Coventry going to make a substitution. And it's Steve Whitten who comes on. to replace Steve Hunt. And we've got a knock just a few moments ago. Stan Bowles really settled in very quickly at Forest. Enjoying his football. It's a new lease of life for him at the end of his career. He was 31 just before Christmas. And that's Ferguson's header and comfortably into the midriff of Shilton. That's Gary Gillespie, and I think I took away from him rather a good header and credited Ferguson with it. Class teams during the 70s have been better for his presence. Now English, Donald, Coote, Francis done quite a lot of covering, Bertels. Long legs went out again, but here's Whitten. That's nicely done, and he tried to chip Shilton, who was coming forward, but he looks well balanced on either side, does young Whitten, 18 year old and a big fella. Through to Seeley. Just a little nudge from Lloyd, although Ferguson was up ridiculously early. Here's Blair. Into the last minute, the ball, Hutchison. Them getting around the flanks, they have that time, and Roberts and McDonald. Now Blair offside against McDonald, won't count, he's offside. But I think that's the first time that they've actually got round on the flanks. Hutchison with a teasing cross, and the ricochet is favouring Nottingham Forest. At the end, McDonald well offside. For Bertels to hold it in the corner, doesn't succeed anyway, and the free kick's given to Coventry. Whitten. And three goals presented by Coventry City give Nottingham Forest their first win away from home in the league since September the 1st. And how ironic that having made plans to mark John Robertson as the provider, he scores two of the goals, the first from the penalty, but more important to Forest, surely, the form of John McGovern in midfield and Kenny Burns at the back. So in the end, a comfortable victory for the European champions to end the 70s. Final score, Coventry 0, Nottingham Forest 3.